When dealing with camera motion in Storyboard Pro, you have to be sure that you're in the camera view. So up until now, we've been working primarily in the stage view, but for working with the camera, you need to be in the camera view. If you don't see the camera view, you can go to this plus icon at the corner of the stage view and select camera view, or you can go to the top menu and select Windows, camera view. Another view that we'll be using a lot of is the timeline view. So once again, if you don't see that, you can bring it up in the same way. So I'm going to go to the motion toolbar and click on the camera tool. And then I'm going to go to the tool properties panel and click on the add keyframe button. Then I'm going to go back to the timeline, drag the playhead across to a random frame, and then click on the add keyframe button again. So to create any camera motion, you need at least two keyframes, a start frame and an end frame. So with the end frame selected, what I'm going to do is hover my cursor close to this blue square box at the top left-hand corner of the second camera frame, and you'll see that there's a variety of different cursors that appear. So the first one is the four-headed arrow, which is used to reposition the camera frame. So if I click on this and then drag my second camera frame toward the top left-hand side, you'll see that it's moved in that direction. You'll also notice that pale blue arrows have appeared that let me know that the camera is going to move from this position, which is what we created on the first keyframe, to this new position, which is what we established for the second keyframe. So I'm going to undo that. Another thing you can do is hold down the shift key to lock the movement to one axis. And this is great for creating pans, whether you're going to pan the camera across or pan it up and down. Next, you'll see the cursor for rotation. Don't get it confused with the cursor for XY rotation because that rotates on the 3D plane. So if we bring up just the regular rotation cursor, you can rotate your camera any which way. And once again, if you hold down shift while doing that, it'll rotate in, I believe, what is 15 degree increments. Lastly, you have this double diamond cursor. And what this does is it actually moves your frame along the Z axis. So in other words, it creates a truck in or a truck out. So in this case, we're trucking out. And if you'd like to see your motion, you can always grab the red playhead in the timeline view and move back and forth like that. You can even put on the camera mask to make it more clear. Or you could go to the playback toolbar and click on the play button.